Hello? Can everybody hear me okay? Hello? Hey, Rick. Good to see you. Is my audio doing okay? Am I reverberating everywhere, or everybody get that okay and can see me all right? Sorry to be looking over there quite a bit to see responses and whatnot. Oh, there's an echo. Thanks, Rick. Thanks, Melina. Bit of an echo too. Okay, let me see if I can find where that's coming from. Is that any better? And the light on me might be not ideal. I'm using the drawing light here, so it's I'm really me being featured on it wouldn't be awesome anyway, so. Start officially sketching it like 505. Oh, maybe I'll start a little earlier. Hi Didier, how are you? I hope I pronounced your name right. Can everybody see the drawing angle okay? Closer in. Okay. So, I'm going to be doing probably some regular traditional drawing, and then at some point I may bring it into digital and walk through a little bit of that process. And the picture I'm going to be working on is somewhat inspired by the strange case from the UK about who put Bella in the witch elm, which, if you haven't heard about that, it is disturbing. The body of a woman was found inside the trunk of a witch elm in Hagley Wood in the UK. And going with a little bit of a Halloween theme, I thought that it conjured some disturbing imagery, so I'm going to give that a go. Let me know if there's any hiccups in the feed or whatnot, and I'll keep my eye on it. I'm going to put myself on mute, unless you want to hear my background music. Let me know in the comments, and I'll check it out. And aside from that, I'm just going to go ahead and draw. If you have any questions, please feel free to jump in. And otherwise, if you want to draw with, feel free. All right. Thanks. For the Hagley Wood, who put Bella in the Witch Elm, I think there's a Dark Histories podcast that actually covers that one a little bit. Can everybody see okay so far? Hey Robert, how you doing? Doing well. Thank you. Oh, for Bly Manor, I did. Oh, thank you for the compliments. I did concept, character concepts, and a few pieces that were in the show as well. Some of the things with the photos and stuff like that, I adjusted. I did artwork for. Like the lady in the water, for example. Where we're at thus far. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring it to digital. What I usually do with that is I will take a photo of it with my iPhone. Working on getting that into the next part. Does anybody have any questions or anything along those lines? I'm sorry, Robert. The question was which lines? Oh, along the lines of the picture or process or anything along that arena. So what I usually do is I photo the work, bring it in, usually on a top layer in, right now I'm using Krita. I use Krita, Corel Painter, Photoshop, whatever happens to be convenient. On the iPad I use Procreate. Is being obnoxious. Oh, there we go. Pardon the hold up there. I think it's because I have a ton of programs working at the same time. Cintiqa are pretty awesome. Thanks for your patience, if you have patience. Appreciate it. Oh, my pleasure. Sorry about the minor glitches here. If this doesn't work out, I'll just jump the idea from scratch and jump in it in Krita based on what I've got so far. So I'm going to email it to myself as well, which sometimes goes a little quicker. again. Pardon the delay. Should be good. Oh, what's Robert asked, do you tend to blur and smudge as much for blending edges when you work digitally? It depends. I think per need in the image, I tend to just go with what the image needs. So if blending is the thing, then I jump in and give that a go. Okay, that should work. There we go. Sorry about the delay there. Okay, let's get back to it. Thank you. I have some sense of what I want the final image to be like. I can actually, I'm diving into some detail just for my own satisfaction. But I'll jump back a little bit and do a little bit more block out and give a sense of some of the emphasis and focus of the scene to help. Can you guys hear me mumbling to myself and humming and other things? I hope I'm not being super irritating. I hope I'm not making you all teasy, as we like to say in Cornwall. Resize this a bit. I think I want it bigger. This is the exciting part, watching me resize documents. Now you might be wondering why I'm not using the fill tool for the background color, and that's because, shut up. Thank you. Hey, Robert. Thanks. Take care. Thanks, Melina. Hey, Bosky Squelch, if I'm saying that properly, my apologies if not. Any of the tree stuff have wool floor around it at all? Yeah, I got to admit, the 4AD stuff kind of influenced me for forever. That music, especially like Dead Can Dance, Cocteau Twins. I'm also a big fan of In the Nursery. They're a Sheffield band. And a couple of others. They really bring about evocative mental imagery that I rarely paint and draw without them. Fantastic stuff. Right, I think that'll do it for the drawing part. If anybody has anything they'd like to discuss or questions or anything along those lines, please feel free to ask. I'll stay on for the next 15 minutes or so, unless it gets really busy with questions, which I don't think it will. But feel free to give over any thoughts or anything you might have, and I'll leave that up for a minute. And if anybody wants to watch this later, I'll edit out the lengthy software battles and pare this down so it's just the drawing information. Thanks, Melina. Right, I think that should about do it. I'm gonna do a few more of these, and if it, with everyone's patience as I go through a learning curve of how to best do these presentations, I'm going to actually try to do them so that they can fit different areas. I want to do one specifically for Europe and the UK. And also India and Iran, and go from there. So I'll post and let anyone know who's interested what time I plan on doing the next one of these. So thanks a lot, and take care.